Hello everyone, this is Namrita. Hope you all are doing good and staying safe. In today's video session, we will be covering another topic in Salesforce Experience Cloud, which is the tile menu. The agenda for today's session, we will be discussing in detail about what is a tile menu, what is a navigation menu. In this navigation menu, you can include Salesforce object, topic, URLs, and create the site pages. So we will be checking all of those in detail, and then we will get into our demo. Now, before we get into today's agenda, we will try to recap what we have discussed in our earlier video session. We have discussed in detail about the Experience Cloud, where we have understood how this Experience Cloud or communities are a great way to share our information and collaborate with people who are very key to our business processes, such as customers, partners, or employees. We went ahead and also discussed about different types of communities, like partner community, customer community, and guest community portal. We understood the difference between all of those three, and we have created customer community. We also went and created a partner community, and we also created a guest community. So the difference between the customer, partner, and the guest community is both of these customer and partner will require a username and password, whereas this guest community portal is mainly an unauthenticated user portal, wherein if the user just have the URL, the user will be able to log in into the portal. It is a publicly accessible community or the experience site. We have also enabled the communities. All of this is something which we have discussed in detail in our earlier video session. So if you didn't had a chance to go through our video, so what I request you is, please go to our SFDC One Stop YouTube channel. Navigate to the playlist tab, and here you will see Experience Cloud. We have covered around 10 plus videos related to the Experience Cloud. If you watch these videos, it will give you some understanding about what we are discussing in today's session, like what is an Experience Cloud, different types of communities, Experience Cloud that we have created, and all the business use cases are discussed in those video session. So I request you all to please go through those videos. Now let us log in to our Salesforce DevOps. So I logged into my Salesforce DevOps from the quick find box, search for the all sites. I clicked on sites. Here under the digital experience, you see this all sites, right? These are all of the different sites that we have created. We went ahead and created the customer community. We went ahead and created partner. And then we also created a guest community portal as well. So we will be making use of the same customer community which we have used in our earlier video session. Now we will try to enhance or modify the existing customer community and make use of the tile menu, navigation menu, and the site pages or different menu items which is available on the navigation menu. So we'll try to open up the builder. Let's click on the builder. So this tile menu is mainly using this tile menu, you can go ahead and do a visually stunning navigation experience to our site. So that is the importance of the tile menu. So we'll see how to use that tile menu. From the components, search for the tile menu here. Under the content, you see this tile menu, right? It clearly says, using this tile menu, you can add an intuitive and visually stunning navigation experience to your page. So that is the importance of this content tile menu. So you can do a lot of enhancements using the tile menu. So here, what I will try to do is, I will drag and drop the tile menu and, you know, put it under this experience, that the headline. When you drag and drop that specific component, here it will ask me to choose the default menu. So for this, you have to create a navigation menu. How to create a navigation menu? Navigation menu, you can create it from the left hand side. You see the settings, right? The gear icon. When you click on the settings, you will see all of these information like general, theme, languages, navigation. Now, when you click on this navigation menu, here you see these are all of the different navigation. So at max, you can create up to, or you can add up to 20 navigation menu. So we have already have 4 here. You can add more, 16 navigation menu. So I already had this demo navigation menu, but for our demo, let's try to create one navigation menu here. I will give it as just a demo. Okay. Then here, this is a menu structure. I will try to create a menu item. As I was mentioning, right, this navigation menu items can include the Salesforce objects, events, you know, the site pages, system link. So you can choose any of these type of menu item that you wanted to make use of. Let's give the name as welcome. And then let us select a site page here. So what will be the use case like whenever somebody is trying to click on this menu items, right? It should navigate me to a separate screen. So for that, we will be making use of this type called as a site page. So here what we will do is we'll try to make use of the welcome page here, but I will try to create that page for you. Okay, so let's leave it as it is. Okay, close it. Now let's go back to the builder. From the home, which you see it on the top side, right? On the top left, gear icon home. Here, navigate to the bottom of the page and click on new page. So what we are trying to do is, since the use case is all about when user clicks on the on that particular menu item, which is welcome, it should navigate to a separate screen. So for that, what we have to do, we have to create a new site page. So here, I will be creating a new site page, making use of the standard page. Then I will just use this full width column. Make it very simple, give the name as welcome because the tile name is also welcome, right? Then give it as welcome, create. I'm creating a site page here. So when you create a site page, it will like by default, a couple of things will be coming up because we have made use of that specific existing page. And here, what we will do is we'll add a we'll make use of a few changes here. What we'll try to do, we'll try to add the rich text, rich content editor here, and then we will edit the content. Welcome to our SFDC one-stop channel. Something like this. Click on home, center, okay. Increase the font. 36, change the color to something like this, bold, italic, you can make a lot of these changes here, okay, you made these changes. Now what we'll also do is we'll add a flow here. Let's add this flow here and let's make use of the existing same, you know, small basic flow. Since this is our demo, we'll just mainly concentrate on this. Now I have added, you made small changes to the welcome page. You have added the flow. And now let's go back to the home page. Or let's go back to our navigation menu. We created this navigation menu, right? And when you navigate to this, here, what is the page that we have created? Welcome. So that page is visible here. When you select the type as site page, whatever the page that we have created, we created a page called as a welcome, right? That particular page is, you will be able to see it in the drop down. Select that particular page and click on save the menu. You did it. Now you completed the navigation menu. Okay, now let's go back to the home. Update the tile menu now. Okay, whatever the tile menu that we have created here, drag and drop. Here you have to choose the default navigation menu, right? So here I will be choosing the demo as a navigation menu. Then if you want to ensure that this navigation menu or the style menu should be visible to certain set of audiences, that you can use it using the personalize. I have created a separate session for audiences, that is, you can go ahead and watch that specific video. But now let us not worry too much about it. You can do a lot of formatting, tile formatting you can do. You can do the text formatting. I will leave all of this as is, okay? Click done. Now, if you wanted to add any other tile menu, right? Let's edit the demo navigation menu. So here you just have welcome, right? Now, when you click on new account, something like this. And then here under the type, I would like to choose the Salesforce object. I'm choosing our object as account and I will see that my account. Just save it. Here you see, likewise you can add number of tile menus here. You can edit the demo. Then if you want thanks, something like this, साइड पेज क्लिक ऑन समथिंग यू नो. सो दिस इज हाउ नाइसली यू कैन एनहांस योर कस्टमर कम्युनिटी पेज. नाउ वी हैव created a tile menu, we also made use of the navigation menu, we have created a site pages, right, we went ahead and created a site page called as a welcome, and we completed everything. Now once you completed all of your changes on your customer builder, you will have to publish your changes. Let's click on publish the changes. So you have completed your business requirement. Now how do you have to test it? You can test it using a customer community user. So I already have this particular customer community user. This is the account. This account has a contact. Now for this specific contact, I have enabled it as a customer community user. Here you see disable customer user, which means it is already an enabled customer user. Then I can click on login as experience user. Use this particular experience cloud, sorry, customer community, which we have built. It will take me to the cloud, it will take me to the customer community page, which I have built. Here you see how nicely the page is structured and how nicely it is visually looking for the end user, right? That is how important or how nicely you can make the changes using the tile menu. Now, whenever the user tries to click on the welcome, that is our use case, right? Whenever somebody clicks on the welcome, that specific menu item, it should navigate me to the separate screen. Now, let us see whether that is working fine or working fine as expected or not. When I click on welcome, it should take me to the welcome. You see here, it is taking me to that new page which I have created, and it will it is asking me some basic information. Now let's go back home. If I click on account, because I have used the Salesforce object here, right, it is giving me all my accounts. Likewise, if I click on thanks, it is again taking me to the same welcome page. This is a new another welcome page I have created. So likewise, you can make use of the tile menu and you can do visually stunning navigation experience for our site of make the UI experience perfectly good for our customers. So this is what we have for today's video session. Until we come up with our next video session, please do take care of yourself, stay safe. Signing off, yours Namrata Kariyala. Bye bye, take care.